Hi, I'm Selena Gomez, and you're watching MSN Exclusive.
Thanks so much for coming up here.
Of course, thanks for
having me. Appreciate it.
Thanks.
So, new record.
Yes, fourth.
I just heard snippets of it.
I know.
It's really nice though. It's all over the place. Like it's musically, it's all over the map.
Exactly.
You got tunes that are like reggae. There was one that I wrote, like a Kesha kind of like hard beat. Yes. And there's the pop songs, obviously the singles and stuff.
Yes.
So maybe we'll start by talking about wanting to diversify the sound of, and making every track literally their own.
I actually appreciate that observation because that's exactly
what I'm here for.
That's exactly what I wanted it to be. You know, I actually had never really had an opportunity to go into a studio and spend so much time working on a record. Before, I was doing my TV show and then I'd have to tour on the weekends. So I literally would go in, record a song, and then it would be on the record. And with this one, I got to go in. I actually would call the producers and writers and explain to them what I was listening to, what I was feeling, what I wanted it to sound like. So I kind of had a couple of influences that for sure inspired me. And you're right, every single track on the record has their own individual style. And mm-hmm. I think that's so cool because I love all types of music. I love all types of genre.
It's an interesting the way it starts. There's some moaning at the beginning, which makes...
Which one?
The first song on the record.
Birthday.
Don't know the titles. No one told me the titles. Just heard the record. Is it called... Look at that exclusive. Birthday. Yeah, you say birthday in a lot. But that's a very mature progression sonically to add those kind of moaning sounds as opposed to being the Disney person you've been known to be over the years.
Sure. But I'm not
necessarily... It's not a bad thing.
Yeah, of course. I think it's more me being able to experiment, you know, going into the booth and actually having the confidence of being like, all right, let me try this. Let me see if this works. Mm-hmm. And messing around with melodies or just harmonies or as you say, moaning.
Is that, well, that's what it is, isn't it? Kind of?
I guess that's the right term for it in a way. But I think in a way I really was able to just play and that was fun for me to do.
How much time did it take? You said you had spent more time in the studio.
About 6 months.
Oh, that is a long time.
Yeah.
So are you, when you're sitting down with these writers, I mean, Esther Dean she seems to be the queen of pop music right now, right? And she wrote the single.
She's just killing it.
So when you sit down with Esther to write a song, does she give you the tune or do you sit down with her and say, here's what I'm thinking. Can we go this way? I don't like these words.
Well, actually, we did reach out to her because I did want to work with her. Who wouldn't want to work with her? And when she thought of me, she actually had this song. So she sent it to me and it was so different. I hadn't heard anything like that before. And I thought it was very smart of her and polite that she gave that to me because it is a different feel for me. And it is a different feel that's on the radio in a way that has that tribal, that urban feel to it. So I was super stoked. And then I went in, I recorded it. I let her have the song. She kind of gave me some of her notes. And then we went back and fixed it up a little bit more. And then that was the single.
Cool. And the next single, you just shot a video for.
I did.
In Paris.
I know.
In France.
That was pretty awesome. I'm not going to lie. That was pretty cool. It was cool, especially because Come and Get It was such a cinematic, almost movie-like video. Mm-hmm. It was very beautiful, and the locations were stunning. And then for this one, we made it a little bit darker. It was a little bit more... Okay. It was a little harsh, and it was cool. The fashion, the hair, everything was very much just tough. It was cool.
Is it a tough song?
Dark tune? Yeah, it's a lot faster. It's a lot faster and it's a lot more, I guess it's got more a little bit of a swag beat to it. Okay. As I call
that's
it.
That's your swag beat? That's a swag
beat? No, please don't let that be that move because that was terrible. But I do dance in the video as well, so.
This dancing thing is becoming...
My thing.
Yeah. Yes. And I hear you want that for the tour.
I do.
It wants to be more of a dancing production than stage lights and effects and all this kind of thing.
Yeah, I think, you know, it does, obviously it helps having incredible things in the background and, you know, all these incredible lights and all of that stuff I probably will 100% add, but I mean, I grew up with Britney and Janet and all these people who just, that's what you do, you entertain and you can bring music to life by choreographing pieces that are amazing. And I have an incredible choreographer who just like completely kills it. So,
do you approach these live shows, like coming from an acting background, I wonder if you approach these live shows from like getting into character on stage and thinking about it like you would a script, knowing that it's a performance and you're almost a character on stage in a way.
Yes, I like to say it's just like more a glamorized version of myself in a way.
Okay.
Because I would not wear a sparkly Vegas-y kind of outfit to the mall, no. But I would wear it on stage. So it's just a different version of myself, I guess.
Cool. We do something called five questions, five quick questions, okay. One word answers.
Oh, dear.
They're easy.
Well, we'll see. But sometimes I'm bad at these, but go.
Okay. Road or studio?
Road.
Lennon or McCartney?
McCartney.
When you hear a song, what usually hits you first? Lyrics, melody, or rhythm?
Lyrics.
Song you've written you're most proud of?
I Won't Apologize.
In one word, Selena Gomez.
Dorky.
Oh, that's a good one. I like that.
Thank you.
You don't seem very dorky.
Oh, no, you don't know me.
I don't know you very well. I hear you want a guy to take you out and bring you ice cream. So what I've done is I've brought you some ice cream. I Googled it, and so a Selena Gomez favorite ice cream, and I don't know if this is correct or what it is, but they said chocolate chip cookie dough or Rocky Road.
It's Rocky Road.
It is Rocky Road.
It's Rocky Road. You are so sweet.
For
Thank you.
You
so
I'm not
going
to take you out and bring ice cream, but I thought I'd bring something to you. It's kind of melting now because it's really hot in here.
Is it? Oh, that's best. I always put it in the microwave for like 10 seconds before I eat it.
What? Why?
Because it kind of makes it good that way.
You like it soupy?
Not soupy. But 10 seconds is the right amount. You don't want it too hard, then you
I've
can't.
I've never. This is a new phenomenon.
No, it's good. Trust me.
Okay.
I'm so happy. That's so sweet. Thank
that's
you.
That's what I do for you. Thanks. Thanks for doing this.
Of course.
You gave me a wrap-up sign, right?
You did.
Yeah, I thought you did. Yeah.
I'm legitimately ready to eat this right now. Holy cow! Okay. Oh my gosh.
You gotta get a little bit of both.
No.
Well, this is the yogurt. I couldn't find the ice cream. So it's healthier, as a matter of fact. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
You can keep this.
That's
I don't need this.
That's so amazing, and I love it. That's actually really good.
It's not bad.
It's good.